In my last video, I had talked about the key steps you need to follow to master Power BI, but I didn't get to the crucial missing step. And this is the step that I actually only recently discovered, and I feel slightly embarrassed because I've been teaching Power BI for many years now. So in this video, we're going to talk about this missing step. So what is this all about? This whole video series has been about solving this problem of the learning doing gap, where people are reading books, they're reading blogs, they're watching videos, they're even signing up for training courses, even including mine, but they're still stuck and not able to apply Power BI. When they start applying to the real business scenarios, they get stuck and can't solve it. And that's where I feel that there was one step that I was missing. So again, the four steps that I covered in the previous video, our program has been structured around those key pillars, those concepts. But there was one step which I was missing as well. That's what we're here to talk about today. Now, if you did not see the last video, make sure to go back and watch it after you're done watching this video. So watch the previous video. We're going to link it to in the corner and down in the description below. But for now, let's just focus on the missing step. By the way, my name is Avi Singh. I'm a Microsoft MVP and a best-selling Power BI author. And if you want to become a Power BI pro, make sure to subscribe and click that bell so you are notified whenever I go live to answer your Power BI questions. All right, so let's say you have learned the 20% core concepts. You have done real practice and you understand when to use push versus pull learning, and you can fill in the blanks in this sentence. Power BI is dash BI, right? And again, if this none of this makes sense, then at the end of it, go back and watch my previous studio, which covered these key four steps. But I saw students who, even after they go through all of that, they still kept getting stuck. And I had to ask myself the question, why? What am I missing? Now, hey, let me walk you through a story, right? Let's imagine you want to learn to play soccer. My son is a huge soccer fan, by the way. It rubs off on me a little bit. So let's say you want to learn to play soccer and you approach the best coach in the world. Nothing but the best for you. But unfortunately for you, the coach turns you down, right? But as you're feeling a little bit sad and depressed and you're walking out of his office, you find right there the coach's playbook with all the different plays and his strategies all inside. So my question to you is, can you become a great soccer player by learning and practicing from the playbook? What do you think? Now, probably won't. That would be my guess. But what is it that the coach teaches besides these steps? And the answer was right in my face, even for Power BI learning. And it is the thought process. Now, what is the thought process and why is it important? Let's talk about that. And of course, how does it fit into Power BI? So what is thought process? Why is it important? So imagine you're being coached, you have gone through the playbook, but the coach has given you one other thing, which is the thought process. Because when you step onto that soccer field, the playbook goes away. Because real life is different. Real soccer is different. People are not going to be in the exact same spots, and you're not going to be able to run the exact same play. So what's crucial is that not only you understand and learn the playbook, right? Learn those concepts, but you learn the thought process behind it so that even when you're exposed to a really new situation, and again, real soccer is going to be different, and even if the players are slightly different, you're still going to know what to do. You're still going to know how to solve this problem. Now, you realize that this is also the number one reason that people are stuck and you know, have this, they can't cross this gap in Power BI, going from learning to doing. Because they're learning kind of this playbook, right? But real data is messy data, right? Real business is always slightly different. Ask yourself, isn't that when you get stuck? Right? I mean, obviously, I mean, if you learn something in the playbook and it's exactly the same, which happens once in a while, you can do it. But if it's slightly different, I guarantee you that is when you're getting stuck. And you go out looking for answers, and again, people, you know, trying to help you and so forth. But again, your case is just slightly different from what they're saying, and it still doesn't work. And you keep spinning your wheels because you're missing the crucial element, the thought process behind it. If you had the thought process, then you would be able to solve any novel problem, right? A soccer player doesn't just go out there and only does the things that they were taught through the playbook. No, he has understood the thought process. Now, the funny thing is that this was staring right in my face. Now, I've been running the Talk Power BS sessions for many years now, at least 2 years, and I've spent hours on there. Now, something that has happened quite often on Talk Power BI is I'm answering somebody's question and I'm trying to solve some DAX or M or whatever puzzle for them, and I'm unable to solve it. It's happened a few times, and every single time I apologize saying, hey, I'm sorry I wasn't able to solve it, felt like a fool, but then inevitably the response was, no, Avi, this was great, because we got to see your thought process behind it. How you approach the problem doesn't matter whether you were or you were not able to solve it. The thought process is what's critical, and I wasn't giving it to my followers, to my students, and I'm like, ugh. So my friends, that I feel is the missing step. Now, if you want to see an example of it in play, then watch this video. And again, it's not about the technique. You may know how to solve this problem. It's not about that, but I bet that you would learn something from my thought process, which I explained in this video. So we're going to link it in the corner and down in the description below. So hey, this is a big moment for us because we are going to pretty much approach everything in this new light. So in my YouTube videos, especially showing Power BI Something Solutions, will not just show you kind of the steps, but will show you the thought process that I use to arrive at that solution, right? Just to give you a peek inside my mind. And of course, we are right now in the process of re-recording Learn Power BI videos to update them, but we're also embedding a little more detail in there, which doesn't just show them the approach, but it shows a glimpse of what's under the cover, the thought process that goes behind, how I think about it, how I approach it. Now, we're also going to use this to revamp our advanced Power BI layer, and really what we're going to do is we're going to go to the recording of Talk Power BI sessions, pick out the best, the starred questions, and re-record them to be modules inside Advanced Power BI where I explain the thought process, which I always do on Talk Power BI, right? I always say I think out loud, but we're going to structure that and put that inside our Advanced Power BI module. We're also going to incorporate this approach in our highest level program, which is Pro Plus. Now, Pro Plus is all about somebody who wants to become really have use Power BI to create a side income or a full-time income working as a freelancer, consultant, entrepreneur, solopreneur, whatever you want to call it, right? So that's my highest level program. And what we're doing there is I'm recording full consulting sessions with clients. And again, Power BI is agile BI, and I talk about how it's like peeling the onion, and I want them to see it. So that is nothing about Power BI. These people are learning to become consultants. But what is my thought process? Like, how am I engaging with a client? And what I'm doing is I'm not only recording the session, but I'm recording a recap of what I taught. And then I go ahead and work on the project, and I come back and say, hey, here's what I did and here's why. So that is what we're working on, and we really hope, we really feel that this was the crucial missing step, and this is going to bring our students and followers so much closer in bridging this gap from learning to doing. So hey, I'm super excited about this. Let me know in the comments if you are too. And again, if you missed the first video, now is the time to go back and watch that. Linked in the corner and down in the description. Keep watching some of our next videos, and don't forget to subscribe, as that really helps support our channel and helps us put out great content. Until next time, power on.